Hello, here we are at Tango number 4. This is the last in the series we're going to do of Tango, and today, as promised, we have 3 new steps that build on other steps that we've covered in this sequence. And those steps are called Contra Rocks, Right Side Fans, and Promenade Pivot. So I'm going to put some music on, so he's going to come out, we're going to just dance those steps, and then we will illustrate those steps and break it down. Oh yeah, here's a couple. Forgot the rose in your teeth. So those 3 steps, again in order, Contra Rocks, Right Side Fans, and a Promenade Pivot. That's what we just showed. First thing we did was a basic just to get into it. So Contra Rocks, probably the best angle is right here. This is Tango's version of a crossbody lead. And if you've looked at other videos that we've done, the rumba, the cha-cha, there's always a crossbody lead step. Well, this is the tango version, right? So remember, just refresher on the basic rhythm. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, and we have that leading foot ready to go again, right? So one dance in which we do that in the basic step. So with the contra rock, the leader is gonna step forward, but immediately change weight and back. For quick, quick, slow. So the first part is quick, quick, slow. And notice my followers perfectly following that and mirroring that step. Quick, quick, slow. But as I hit that second or hit that slow, I'm going to be turning so I can do the same thing on the other side. So quick, quick, slow. Opening up. Quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow. And quick, quick, slow. Contra Rocks is done in that sequence of a double. That's important in a line of dance like tango because we're moving counterclockwise around the room. If we only did one, we'd be facing in the wrong direction against the line of dance, right? So one more time to illustrate. Quick, quick, slow, and quick, quick, slow. Quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. And now we're ready to move into the next step, which could be a basic, it could be something else, right? So, from the follower standpoint, it's just like a crossbody lead, right? You're getting, the leader's giving you a signal by opening this way, right? And maybe dropping the hand a little bit and then putting some pressure, not grabbing, not gripping, but pressure to lead. Mainly, again, like always, we're going to be leaders with this hand on the shoulder. That's what's going to tell it to come across. Quick, quick, slow, and quick, quick, slow. Anything to add to that?
Absolutely not.
Yeah. Okay. So that's your contra rocks. Again, it's a very good step to use in the line of dance, especially if there's a bit of a clog in the dance floor and you don't want to just kind of stand still marching in place doing basics. Because you're not going to take up a whole lot of space, right? You're basically just turning around. So you go that direction, come back this direction, you end up where you started. And then with luck, the clog will then dissipate. You can move on. Second step we want to show is the right side fan. Now, refresher. We did a couple of steps that get you ready for this. One was the reverse turn, right? Quick, quick, slow, and quick, quick, slow, right? And we use that as the basis for showing a, first of all, a corte. Well, corte was not a term, the double corte. Quick, quick, slow, slow, and quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. You can think of a right side fan as a variation on that. Instead of going in the quarté, leaders are going to go into what's called contrabody, right? And because of that movement, we'll be pulling the follower back to the leader's right, and then setting up for the fan, which we'll just show, and then we'll break it down. So we are beginning just as we would for a double quarté. Quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, and quick, quick, slow. Again, we do it twice so that we stay in the line of dance. And the rhythmic pattern works out the way it should. So just showing it again, and how it's best, leaders, if you are, you could be straight down the line of dance and do this, but it's best if you're angled a little bit to the inside, right? Or what's called diagonal center. A little bit of a diagonal pointing to the center of the room. Quick, quick, slow, slow. Quick, quick, slow, slow, and quick, quick, slow. So lead points, most important thing, is that contrabody. So when I come around, quick, quick, slow, I'm not just leaving my body in the same position. The feet are important, obviously. So I'm going forward, side, back. But when I hit that back move, that slow, I'm also twisting my upper torso out. My follower's here. So when I twist the upper torso, because we have a nice sturdy frame, she's going to come along with that. She's going to come along with that movement, right? And it's creating momentum so that when I give her that next slow, that leg is going to come around and step forward, right? So let's show it again, and then we'll talk about the follower's part. Quick, pick, slow. This is the contrabody. Slow. Quick, quick, slow. Slow. Quick, quick, slow, right? So, follower. This is definitely a trickier part. Oh, and the other thing I wanted to say, the lead, always this is important, but it's really important on these kind of moves because you have to use this as sort of like your rudder, right? So you're not only using the upper frame, but you're applying some additional pressure here, especially on that next slow where she has to fan, because you're saying, don't stop there, keep on coming around, right? So the follower's part, watch Sylvia's feet. Quick, quick, slow.
Stepping forward on my right, my weight. Right.
Now with that momentum of contrabody and the coming out of it and this, slow.
Now my head has to go in that direction.
Right.
Then I
come
out.
Quick, slow. So, well, okay, that broke down.
Well,
on the second one.
Well,
quick,
okay,
quick.
I didn't want you to stop.
No, that's all right.
Okay.
So just, we will stop this time on just the first one. Quick, quick, slow, and slow, right? So ideally, we're going to actually be a little bit more in this position so we can get around that second time. Quick, quick, slow, here's the fan. Quick, quick, slow, here's the fan. Quick, quick, slow, right? That's why right side fans, right? It's right side of the leader. Orientation is always in reference to the leader. Sorry, that's the tradition. That's the way they worked it out, right? So then the follower is fanning on that second slow, right? Okay, so notice that we may not be perfectly around, and that's okay, because you can always correct. In fact, with a lot of these steps, even when the pros do it, they're not getting all the way around, so they're not coming back into perfect alignment after that second turn, the second fan, right? But that's fine. You could be like, end up here, line of dance is there, you could easily correct, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, right? Okay, so that's number two, right side fans. The final step, we call this the closing challenge step, because it's a little bit trickier in terms of lead and follow, And it has a little bit different rhythm to it. That's the promenade pivot.
But also in this pivot, you are actually making contact with your leader, and you're actually oppressing yourself against the body so that you're moving as one.
Yeah, so this is one of those steps. We said when we started off this series that you can dance American style tango without close body contact.
Not this.
Right. So you can do most of your steps, so even though, like, if you're really into tango, you have a hip connection, but you can do your basics just like this. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, right? No problem. You really can't execute this step properly without being close. So,
because
if you're not dancing with a partner that you feel comfortable with, you probably wouldn't want to lead this step.
The follower's leg actually goes between the legs here, and there's a close connection. Yeah. And then you don't really have to worry about where you're going because your leader will take you around.
You're going to be pulled around.
Right.
So, but let's show it, and then that'll make more sense. Okay. So we're in a promenade position. I think this would be a good angle to show it. So the first slow is just like any promenade. And we can do different things from that, right? We can do our basic promenade, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. We could do a throw-up, which we've done several different, well, at least a couple of different versions of that, right? Slow, slow, and quick, quick, slow. The follower would not know from that first move, that first step, that first slow, which of those options was coming. But the second is going to tell her, slow, slow. Because what I will do as a leader is now I'm going to get a little bit ahead of her, and I'm going to cut her off with this right foot coming out in front. That's going to tell her right away that, okay, this is not going to be a regular promenade, because you couldn't do it from that, promenade basic, nor is it going to be one of these throw-outs with a walk around or throw-out with a change of position. It's going to be a pivot, right? So, again, we've done slow, slow. Now I'm going to come around. This is what Sylvia was talking about in terms of the close contact and the leg, you know, the feet being in between the feet, because I'm going to go slow, quick, quick, slow. That's the first part. Let's do that again, all in one fluid motion. Ready? Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. And we should be more or less back down the line of dance when we complete that, right? So one more time that, and then we'll add the second piece to this. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. Probably that quick, quick, slow is the trickiest part, because this is where we have to quick. She's gonna step in between. I'm gonna step in between.
It's hard to do it slowly.
When you break it down, it's hard. It's, when you do it as a fluid motion, it is better. Slow, slow. Here we go. Quick, quick, slow. All right? So we're just kind of rotating on that pivot, hence promenade pivot. So once we do that, we need to come out of it. So we'll do the first part again, and then we'll emphasize coming out of it. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, 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 slow. So notice we may have gotten outside the frame yet. That quick, 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 slow is needed in order to complete the right rhythmic structure. Don't worry about that, it's just a metric thing, right? So we're not just gonna go quick, quick, slow and end it. We're gonna go quick, 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 slow. So the whole thing again, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, 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 slow. So you may have noticed, we didn't get perfectly around when we turned. That's okay. I mean, you can always correct for that with the continuation of the steps. So if you find yourself a little broken and you're pointing here when you should be pointing there, just keep with the same rhythm and pull yourself back into line, right? So we do that again. Slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, 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 slow. Not everybody's the same, but I'll tell you, when I first learned this stuff, the hardest thing was remembering the count, right? Tango does not follow a standard slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, which if you've watched these other videos, that's already clear. So it changes, right? You have a slow, slow, quick, quick, slow. You have a slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, 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 slow.
That's clear as
you have a quick, quick, slow. And here we have a slow, slow, quick, slow, slow, quick, slow, right? So there are different counting structures, you might say. But it's those variations that allow you to do more complex steps and just different steps, steps that have a little bit of a different feel to it. All right, so that's it. We're gonna end the series with that promenade pivot altogether. I think it gives you 12, maybe 13 steps. In,
so if you wanna become a professional dancer,
tango.
Just go through all these steps.
Well, if you wanna be a professional dancer, go get professional instruction.
That's right.
For sure. So I'm gonna put some music on, we're gonna dance those steps first, and then we'll just do some of the other things we've done, not necessarily a complete set, but just some of the other tango. And again, Anne at the Y and Paula at the OSHA Center has contact information if anybody wants to get in touch with us about any of this stuff or dance opportunities in the Hattiesburg community. Hope to see you somewhere down the road on the dance floor. It may happen yet. Start with the basic. That's gonna do it!